Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome to my channel. Today what we're gonna do is put some LED lights on my Ninja 650. I went through a couple of them, couldn't make them fit. Now I think I came up with a plan. So I ordered those off Amazon a few days ago. They just came in. Currently I do have some LED lights on it, but they're the ones without the fan in the back and they're not bright. They're not bright at all. So today what we're gonna do is take the fairings out, install the new LEDs that I got, and I'll put a link in the description for you guys to get it if you guys want. But yeah, that's what we're gonna do today. Take the fairings out first and then install the lights. Let's do it. All right, first we gotta take out the windshield. We got four bolts. You got those little washers, plastic washers, make sure you don't lose them. Those are out. Windshield is out. Next, you have to take this little plastic off. So you got those little clips. You just push them in. It pops right out. Now you have access to those three bolts that are holding the fairing in. Okay, let's take this one out. You got one bolt. Same thing with all the washer. Make sure you don't lose it. And this one, it has a clip in the back and a clip down here. You just pop it right out. Same thing on the other side. Now you have a few bolts that are a little bit bigger than this, but first you need to take out the bottom fairing. Three bolts. One. Two. Three. And the fourth one is just a little bit bigger, so I'm gonna turn the head on this thing. There you go. Just a little bit bigger. So get those out. Oh, you got three clips right here in the front. Just onto the bike. You will need the screwdriver to pop them off. There's one. There's two. Three clips. Now can you gently pull this out? That's the bottom fairing.
Same thing on the other side.
All right, once you got the other side off, you get a couple more screws that hold the fairing in place. This one right here, I know my fairing is cracked because my bike was salvage, but they were just the fairings. So this bolt right here, and then this one pops right off, and it's one more right here underneath this one. So one, two on this side, one, two on this side, and then three right here on top. One, two, three. Those are 10 millimeter bolts. So what you want to do after you loosen those up, pull the fairing a little bit, set it down on the fender if you want, or if someone can help you, that's great. Got to disconnect the tachometer, speedometer, and all that stuff. This is it. You can plug that thing up, and then on the bottom it has like a little tab. Press it up, and then it'll come right out. So this is one. And there's a couple more wires they have to disconnect, but I'll show you when I get in there. All right, so one here. One here. Same thing on the other side. Now the fairing, it still has those little tabs they have to pull out, rubber. So I'm gonna loosen up the front and I'll show you what wires to disconnect. Now the fairing is loose, just held on by the bolts in the front. Now, all this is loose. And I'm gonna bring the camera and show you what to disconnect. Right, you got this up, and then you'll have to disconnect the headlights first. So hold it up, pull your headlight wire, that's one. Two, and then you'll have those. I'm not sure if you guys can see it on the fairing. It has a clip where it goes to the turn signal. You can unclip the wire off of it, and then you just unclip the wire itself. That's one. It has one more little wire for the running lights. Little tab right here, push it up, boom, disconnected. One side is out, the other side it should be the same. It's one, and then take the cable off. Now disconnect the turn signal. Fat fingers can get this little clip off. There you go. Now gently pull your fairing out. All right, so this is how you take your fairing off
Ninja 650, 09-2011. Right now what we're gonna do, I'm gonna get a rag or something to put this fairing upside down and take the bolts out, I mean the light bulbs out, and swap them out with the LEDs. Right, now that you've got this in place, secured on the nice soft surface, you gotta take out the dust covers. It's one, there's two, and then you'll see the lights. Gotta take the lights out, put this clip out. And this is the lights I'm running right now. There's some LEDs. Those are crappy LEDs, and I'm gonna swap them out with those LEDs, the real deal. Just got them off Amazon today. Hopefully they're working great. About to find out. So a lot of people said that they couldn't fit the LEDs because this connector, it's wider than this, so you won't go in a harness correctly, right? Basically what this black part is, and I found out on the hard way, is actually a just connector, and this one is the same size as this one. Granted that they're both LEDs, but the halogen ones are the same. And now, a lot of people, me included, if we put the LED light on as it sits right now, without this black part, if I put it in and put a clip over it, right, this will still be wobbling around. This will wobble around and move. So I have to figure out a way how to secure those right. All right, to fully show you what I'm talking about. See, the LED light is inside. The clip is over it and clipped in here how it's supposed to be. And now the light is just moving around because it doesn't have this quarter inch thick plate for this spring to rub against and then keep it secure. And a lot of people, they're saying that they're modifying, they're cutting their dust covers just to keep it secure, but I don't like that idea. So I'm gonna make something up. All right, so what I come up with is, I tried different things, man. I tried making my own type spring with longer arms. It's not working. Basically what I did, got some wire, took the spring out. Gotta do it for this one. I just have to take the unscrew it a little bit, loosen it up. Can pick up the spring and then wire twist it to make this end a little bit thicker and make this end a little bit thicker. And this is what I did, wrapped it around like that. I'm probably gonna put some epoxy on it, and right now it's snug. It's not moving anywhere. It's pressing really hard against the light bulb and the housing, and I'm sure everything is gonna be fine. This connector right here, this is plastic, so I know this wouldn't melt because of the heat. I had the other LED running and they were fine. I had the halogen bulbs which are running a little bit hot too. So if this plastic can hold, that wire right there can hold also. This one, you can pick up a bunch of them at the dollar store. I don't even know where they are. In what aisle, but dollar store, about a auto department, or
Auto Pieces aisle or something like that. You can find it really thin. You only took about like a foot to do all both sides. So yeah, everything gets good and snug now. I'm gonna do it this way, this side. I'm gonna show you guys how I did it. And we'll put it back together, install it, and put the fairing back on and see what they look like.
All right, since I took the spring out, basically what we're gonna do is start wrapping the ends. Just put it like this, start looping around close to each other. Oh yeah, I tried some aluminum foil to make like a ring, press against the thing, but it's not working. So, loop this around like so to make it thick. Go all the way back up and go all the way back. Keep going. Until it's about a little bit than a quarter thick. About that. I know this is not the nicest way to do it, but you know what? It works. I'll update the video if it's not working. At the other end, you just loop it around a couple of times. Make sure it's snug in there. Boom, this is one end. And the other end is right here. We're gonna do it. Let's see. Oops, plastic. There you go. Go on one side, go on the other side, and come back down. Do that a few times. Couple more times. I think we are good to go. We're gonna cut it. Just loop it back a few times. This is snug. And now, let's put it in.
What I will do, I will put this in first on the light bulb or around the light bulb. There you go. You guys can see it's really tight on there. Now, insert the light bulb in there and put this into the slot, tying this down. The light bulb moves a little bit, you just have to come up to that little slot right here. You guys can see it under that. To not move left and right. Once we did that, all we have to do is clip this over the tab. Let's see. There you go. Perfect. This is tight. It's not going anywhere. So this is the cheap way to do stuff. Because I am pretty cheap. Yeah. Make sure everything is secure in there. And it is. Spring is good. This is tight. You can leave it like that. Or you can put some epoxy coating on it, make sure it doesn't come off. But I'm sure it won't come off. Tie it this out of side. All right. So yeah, the light bulbs are secured. Now we have to put it on the bike, turn on the bike, and see how they look. Oh yeah, since we're here, we gotta put the connectors back on. This is from one side. You have to connect it. What was it? This way or the other way? Oh, don't matter. Well, it kind of matter. This is, what is plus, what is minus? Well, we're about to find out. I'm gonna put it one way or the other. We put it in, see if they work. It's one, it's two, and let's see. All right, now that we got a bearing connected, I mean on the top, we just connect the lights. Again, I don't know which one is plus, which one is minus. I'm not sure if it matters on those, but I'm pretty sure it does. Right, let's see. Haven't connected the corner lights, but let's test out this thing. Alrighty, so that was it for the video. What you gotta do now is just connect the rest of the cables, the rest of the light cables and the dash, which is not connected. Screw everything back together, and that's it. So far, so good. I'll see if I can put the dust covers on. If I do end up putting the dust covers on, it's gonna be right after this. If not, I guess it works as is for now. I think with the dust covers on, it's gonna be better because of the water to not get in when you wash the bike and stuff like that. But I don't know. I don't know how much water is gonna get behind the fairing. When you wash it, I guess when you power wash it, it does. But all right, let's see if we can put the dust covers on. If not, this is it. All right, so what I did, I ended up putting the dust covers back on just because I just didn't want to get moisture or water into there, into the housing. So basically what I did, this is the dust cover. I cut out this piece right here, or mushroom, up to this ledge, and I put it around the fan, around the LED fan, so it won't cover it, blocking the air to cool the LED. What you want to do, start it on one side just above that lip, cut it around. And this is what you're gonna end up with. Ta-da! Now we gotta put it back on. Uh, Oh, I also marked those, the connectors, since the lights are working. I marked them with white so I know where he goes. And the other one is connected, it's marked up also with a wiring harness, just to make sure everything is goes back in place the same way. Right. Do top with the bottom of the fan first. Go around. You can use a small screwdriver. Go around. LED. Go around just like this. And voila! We got this dust cover back on. Put it back together. Basically,
that's it.
Right. That was it. No more. Thank you for watching. If you want to subscribe to my channel, go ahead, subscribe, like this video, share if you want. But yeah, thank you for watching, and I hope I see you next time. Ride safe.